In this lecture we will discuss about the design of breakwater. This shows the Google image of the Ennore breakwater, pair of breakwaters. Always breakwaters are pair of breakwaters with the opening for the vessel to enter here, and this is the coal berth, and here we see through three small arms. These three small arms are for tugboats which are used to bring the vessel here. The temporary structure for iron ore terminal, and from here we have the coal which is coming through this conveyor system and going to the thermal power plant. And here, because of the construction of the breakwater, there is advancement of sewer line from here to here, a sand deposition. So we will be discussing about the design of the breakwater in this lecture. So this shows the details of breakwater. We have to have certain glossary of terms. So whenever you build a breakwater, you have to mark two sides. One is on the sea, that is ocean side, another is on the harbor side. Then we have to show what is the crest. This is the crest of the breakwater. This is your seabed level. What is the bed level? Seabed level. And we normally provide a bedding layer on the seabed. Then we have the core layer. Then we have the second under layer, first under layer, armor layer. These are the various layers, and we have what is known as a design high water, and then still water level. Then we have this water depth. This is one of the main parameter for the design. Then we also have the toe. The toe has to be designed. We have the slope on the seaside and the slope on the harbor side. These are the parameters. And to fix the top level, we have to have this height above the design high water, that is HC. So what we are going to design is a rubble mount breakwater, for which we need to design a filter layer, core layer, toe layer, and you may or may not have armor layers. You may have only under layers. You may have only one under layer, first under layer, or you may have two under layers. Then we have the armor layers. Main thing is to design this W, weight of the armor stone. That is the main purpose. For the design, what is required is the wave height for which we are designing. The input parameter is the wave height, the type of soil here, and we have to find out armor layer. This also depends on the slope. Whatever slope you are assuming, based on which your armor layer weight will change. For functional requirements, you should know what is the width a vehicle has to go. So maybe 8 meter may be required. That is based on functional things. Now it has various connotations, but we have various tidal ranges, mean sea level, lowest low water spring, high water spring, and all. Still water level, they will use it for the mean sea level. You know what is the tidal range, no? Average of the tides will give you the mean sea level. Design high water level is highest high water level plus storm surge. The failure of the breakwater will take place, if at all it takes place, it will take place during a storm. During a storm, when a highest high water spring takes place, then there can be a damage. So the design water high water is highest high water plus the storm surge. For construction purpose, we need this still water level. When you are building the breakwater, no, typically you put a core layer, armor layer, and all. It should be, the armor layer should be above the still water level during for construction purpose. That is why still water level is required, because it generally that gives mean sea level. That is not used for design purpose, it is used for some other purpose. What is your doubt? I didn't get your doubt.
Is the still water level or mean sea level both are same, or is
it? It is same. What are the functions of the breakwater? To maintain tranquility conditions inside the harbor. To protect the shore against the waves. This also can be another function of breakwater. We call it as a groyance. and to reduce dredging at harbor entrance. If we don't build the breakwater, the siltation will be more and the dredging will be, the entrance will be more. And we can also use the breakwater as a key facility, and then we can use it to guide currents. These are the functions of the breakwater. Rubble mound cannot be used as a key facility. This shows layout of the breakwater. We always have a pair of breakwater, and this is for a marina. In foreign countries we have marina where we have the pressure boats that are being used inside. We have to design typically two sections. One is called as a trunk section, another is called as a head section. The difference between trunk and head is, head section you will have slope on three sides, trunk section you have slope on two sides. Clear, no? Because it is at the entrance, it is facing all the three sides, you have the slope, that is called, you will have a head section here, you will have a head section here also. And this trunk section we have shown BB, CC, CC and all. So you will have different sections. It is not that you will be providing, designing only one section. The water depth varies from 0 meter here, it goes up to 10 meter let us say. We will put 0 to 5 meter one design, 5 to 7 another design, 7 to 9 another design, 9 to 10 another design, like that. It is not one water depth you have to design, you have to design it for different water depths so that you will get the economy. And another thing required is what is the direction of the waves. Waves can come in different direction. Normally we assume the direction of the wave is perpendicular to the alignment of the breakwater. That will be the most severe condition, that is what we assume. We will assume the direction is perpendicular to this breakwater. We will be concentrating more on rubble mound breakwater because this is the most widely adopted for Indian ports. Most of the ports, 99% most means, we have only rubble mound. I said there is a slope, seaward slope and harbor side slope. The seaward slope is between 1:2 to 1:2.5 and harbor side slope is 1:1.5 to 1:2. So in the first slide I have shown what is the seaside and what is the harbor side. Seaside the slope is flatter, flatter the slope weight of the stone will be less, steeper the slope weight will be more. But in the harbor side you do not have waves, only in the seaside you have the waves. That is why we provide a flatter slope, 1:2 to 1:2.5. Whenever you design any structure, all these things are to be used as a guideline. Do not put 1:5 slope, do not put 1:1 slope. Structure will not only fail, you will be putting very huge size of stone, okay. Whenever you want to design any structure, there are certain guidelines which you have to follow. In the head of the breakwater, the slope is still flatter, 1:3 to 1:5. So this slope is 1:3 to 1:5. This slope is 1:1.5. This slope is 1:2. Is it clear? This is the sea side, 1:2. Harbor side, 1:1.5. In the head section, it is 1:3. 1:3 means one vertical to three horizontal. Why do we go for this in Indian ports? Mainly because it is very easy to construct, it is not very difficult, but it takes a very long time. A breakwater construction will typically take more than 2 years for a greenfield port. So when the damage will take place? Damage will take place due to poor interlocking capacity between individual blocks. This we will discuss. We have what is known as a stability coefficient. The stability coefficient depends on the interlocking of the blocks. The interlocking of the blocks, it depends on the type of block we are using. If it is artificial armor units, the interlocking is better. Natural stone interlocking is not that good, but still we can use natural stones. If it is available nearby, the cost is cheaper. So where large size natural rocks are not available, or to increase the interlocking capacity, artificial armor blocks are adopted. Only these two conditions we use artificial armor blocks. And even if we use the artificial armor blocks, we may use for 0 to 5 meter only natural rock. After 5 meter we will start using the artificial armor blocks. It is not that throughout we will use the artificial armor blocks. Up to 5 meter water depth, natural rock as armor unit is more than sufficient. The water depth is more than 5 meter only, we need artificial armor units. That is another guideline. Up to 5 meter natural rock, more than 5 meter artificial armor if required. So use of natural material is a big advantage, especially when large quantity of rubble stones are available near the site. This reduces the material cost. Material cost means the alternative to rock is concrete. Concrete cost is very high. Who are all civil engineers here? What is the cost of concrete?
5 to 6 rupees per kg.
Concrete in per cubic meter, what is the cost? You are telling the cost of cement, I think.
In kg.
Per cubic meter, how much it is?
Three thousand rupees.
One answer. Another answer. How many bags will go into concrete? One cubic meter of concrete, how many bags will go?
Depends on the grade.
12,000 per cubic meter.
How much?
12,000.
I am not asking the cost. I am going to answer to the previous question. 12,000 is very high. 12,000 rupees is very high. I am asking how many bags or how many kgs of cement will go into a cubic meter of concrete.
Depends on the grade.
You tell me. M30 grade you answer.
So 350 kg, 7 bags.
What is the maximum quantity of cement you can put in concrete?
360 kg per meter.
It is given in IS 456.
Yes.
Revised, latest version. Maximum cement that can be put in a concrete. 450 kg per cubic meter. What is the weight of one bag of cement?
50 kg.
So 9 bags is 450. You should not put more than 450 kg of cement in 1 cubic meter of concrete. What is the cost of per bag? Cost of cement per bag?
300.
300. 250 to 300. 300 will take. 300 into 9 bags is 2700. So your 3000 rupees is gone in cement itself. Typically it is about 4500 rupees per cubic meter if it is on land. If you have to put the same concrete in offshore, it will go up to 9 to 10,000 rupees per cubic meter. What is the cost of stone, quarry stone? Cost of stone, just guess. This is 4500 rupees per cubic meter. What will be the cost of 1 cubic meter of stone? What will be the weight of 1 cubic meter of stone? 1 meter by 1 meter, you put the stones, what will be the weight? How much? What will be the weight of concrete? 1 cubic meter.
2400 to 2500 kg.
What will be the weight of stone in 1 cubic meter? You have told 3000. How it can be more than the concrete weight? Cubic meter concrete is 2500 kg per cubic meter. Cubic meter stone means you are not dressing a stone to 1 cubic meter. You are filling the stone. There will be voids. Okay, void ratio is how much? Suppose you fill the stone, 40 mm stone or 150 mm stone or 1 meter by 1 meter stone, you stack it, there will be voids. The voids are very important. Your dissipation of wave energy takes place through the voids only. How much will be the void ratio? What we are discussing for non-civil engineers is, if you take a container of 1 meter by 1 meter, and put 40 mm size, that is the road size material what we are using, and you are putting it in that, there will be voids. How much will be the voids? 5%, 10%, 20%, 30%, 40%. 30% is correct answer, but it varies between 30%, 25 to 40%, depending on the size of the aggregate. smaller the size of aggregate, the void ratio will be less. Bigger the size, the void ratio will be more. But 30% is correct answer. What is the density of stone?
1.7.
Density of stone.
2.7.
Somebody said 1 point and all. 1 point is totally wrong. 2.7. But we have in Tamil Nadu some place where the stone density is 3.3 near Jinji and all. Anybody from that place? Kadalur, Jinji side? Nobody here, because we are doing some breakwater in Kadalur. We are making the weight estimate using 2.65, that is normally used. But this fellow told 3.3, we never believed, but finally when we saw the density was 3.3, it's a good quality stone. Normally it is exported to Japan where they put this stone carvings on this symmetry and all. So it's polished so nicely. Tamil Nadu, there are some places where we get very good granite blocks. There the density is 3.3. Suppose it is take 2.65, take void ratio is 0.3, density will be 2.65 into 1 minus 0.3, that is 2.65 into 0.7, it's about 1.7. So 1 cubic meter will be 1700 kg. 1 ton of stone, depending on where it is available, is normally doesn't exceed more than 700-800 rupees. So 1 cubic meter will be maximum 1500 rupees. Concrete is 4500, so it is 1/3 cheaper. Which one is 1/3 cheaper? Stone. That is why we go for this. Then we need smaller construction equipment, less environment impact due to smaller reflected waves. Stones are having very high void ratio, and then creation of a natural reef. The slope of the Rebel Mount breakwater provides suitable place for sea life. When you go to the breakwater site, lot of sea, that fishes, crabs and other things, they take it as a place for nesting and living. So we have the components to be designed, what is called as a superstructure, what is called as a foundation. The superstructure consists of a armor layer that is shown here. It shows an under layer, single or many. It shows a core layer. Then in the foundation you have the toe beam and filter layer. I think the color has not come in this. I think toe beam will be here and filter layer will be here. This is a classification. When you want to design, you should know what is a superstructure, what is a foundation. Superstructure design, normally the influence of seabed properties are not much, whereas the foundation, it will be influenced by the seabed properties. That is why we classify between superstructure and foundation. Superstructure design is mostly affected by the wave climate. Foundation design is mostly by the seabed properties. So whenever we want to design, there are three components for the design. One is estimation of force, second one is analysis, the third one is design. A poor structure and a better structure, optimum structure and expensive structure, mostly it depends on the force estimation. The force estimation is not done properly, the structure will fail. Many places whenever there is a failure, it is mainly because, not poor design or analysis, it is mainly because of wrong estimation of forces. If they don't estimate the force properly, the structure will fail. So you have to concentrate more. In undergraduate, you will be concentrating more on design. But if you want to become a professional designer, you should concentrate more on forces. The significant force is a wave force. In addition, we have to consider current force, buoyancy force, frictional resistance, bonding between two members, then other forces like impact during construction. These are the forces, but mostly we will be using only the wave forces for the design. The size of the stones or the armor layer is a function of wave height HS. HS is the significant wave height. So if you know the significant wave height, the armor layer weight is a function of significant wave height. The weight of other under layers, core layer and other things is a function of armor layer unit weight. The empirical formulation. So the armor layer, we have a formula called Hudson's formula that depends on HS. HS means cube of HS. So if you don't calculate HS properly, there will be a lot of issues which you have to address. Either it become unsafe or it will become very expensive. What is the type of failure? The type of failure will be the rolling down of the stones, which becomes quite severe if the toe protection is improper. When the rolling down of stones will take place? When the design wave height what you assumed and the wave height what has occurred in a storm is different. That is, during a storm, if it has more wave height than it is designed for, then there will be rolling down of stones. There won't be complete failure. There will be some rolling down of stones, but that also will become severe only if you don't have the toe protection. That is why toe protection is important. The other effect is effect of wave grouping, which need to be considered. So there is a breakwater which is done by very good designers. I forgot the name now. I think it is in France. That has failed. Everything was done properly. Then they found out the problem is because of wave grouping. Wave grouping means the same HS. Suppose about for a period of, let us say, about 5-10 minutes, the waves are coming in a group with the same HS, then it will fail. I will explain the figure and tell you later what is this wave grouping. I will show the time series and then let you know. Then another thing is inadequate crest level in case of non-overtopping breakwaters may lead to damage of its leeward side. We have two types of breakwater. One is called as a overtopping breakwater, another is non-overtopping breakwater. Overtopping breakwater means from the sea side, the water will go on top of the deck and go to the other side. That is overtopping. We design non-overtopping also. So when you have a non-overtopping breakwater design and the water level spills over, there may be damage on the leeward. Leeward means that harbor side. So these are the design components. We will see one by one how to design this. I will show you one typical example. I have shown mean water depth. He was asking, this is from the still water level, water depth is 4 meters. The tidal correction, it can be due to high tide level or it can be due to storm surge. We are giving it as 0.8 meters. This is the input data what is given for you in the design. Water depth is 4 meter. On top of 4 meter, you have additional 0.8 meter of storm surge that is coming into place. We have the stability coefficient 2. This is for armor units consisting of rock. This is also data which is given to you. If it is artificial armor, it can be 6, 8, 10, 12 like that. Okay. This is the data which is given. Unit weight of armor is given as 2.65 tons per cubic meter and unit weight of seawater is 1.025 tons per cubic meter. What is the unit for force? Newton or kilonewton? What is the unit for this unit weight? Should be kilonewton per cubic meter only. But in design, we normally use tons. So be familiar with this. Ton is normally a mass unit. 1000 kg mass is defined as a ton. But here it is a force unit. If you go, some of you may go abroad, there they will use kips. What is kips? KIPS. What is kips? Don't know. Kips is kips is kilopounds. Kips per inch square, that's what they will see, material strength and all. So be familiar with the units. I am telling about the units because most of the people, when they do the design, common mistake they make is they don't see the consistency of the unit. Consistency of the unit means, if you get this formula substituted in this, the weight of the armor unit will come in tons. You have to substitute proper units. If you use tons per cubic meter, water depth should be in meter, wave height should be in meters. I have seen many people, if the, in the example they have given the wave height is in centimeter, they will directly substitute centimeter. So you be very careful whenever any equation is given, whether it is a analytical solution or a semi empirical solution, it's more important in semi empirical solution they should write what the unit in which the equation is valid. Sometimes some of the semi empirical equations are valid only in certain units. Analytical equation, analytical equations means it is, it has a basis, from the equation it will be derived. M by I is equal to F by Y is equal to E by R, all of you studied that equation, no, Euler's equation, that is analytical equation, from there you can get the stress. But the equation what I am going to show is a semi empirical equation for the breakwater design. So these are the various steps, step by step design water depth 4.8 meter. Maximum wave height is, so you may wonder I have not given wave height here. See, all along I was telling wave height is the governing parameter for design. I have given a problem without wave height. So if this example I ask the question, don't ask me, sir, what is the wave height? You are not supposed to ask that. Is it clear? There is some reason for that, I will explain in the next slide. Wave height is not given, don't ask in the exam. We have maximum wave height, that is 0.78 into water depth. Ocean engineering students, you know what is the 0.78? Wave breaking. If you go to the beach and when you see the waves, waves will be breaking. If you sail in a ship, go to mid ocean, you will see the waves without breaking. Sometimes in the mid ocean also waves will break. If you come to our department, when we generate the waves in the basin, waves without breaking will occur. When it goes to the absorber other end, waves will break. Okay, wave breaking is by two criteria. One is depth dependent wave breaking. What is the other one?
Steepness.
One is based on the other is, what
steepness.
Is it? Wave steepness. What is wave steepness?
HPL ratio.
HPL ratio. Board focus. So I will tell you what is the wave now. அந்த பையனை எழுப்பி விடு, அவனை தூங்க வேணாம்னு சொல்லு, இல்லைன்னா அவனை போ சொல்லு கிளாஸ் விட்டு. கேமராவிலலாம் தூங்குற மாதிரி வேணும்பா, இல்லை கட் பண்ணுங்க. This is the water line. போட கீழே வரைக்கும் ஃபோக்கஸ் ஆகும்ல, தட் இஸ் த வாட்டர் லைன். ஸோ திஸ் லெவல் கேன் பி டிசைன் வாட்டர் லெவல். ஸோ திஸ் டெப்த் இஸ் 4.8 meter. யுவர் பிரேக் வாட்டர் மே ஸ்டார்ட் ஃப்ரம் ஹியர், வில் கோ அப் டு 4.8 meter, இட் ஸ்டாப்ஸ். பட் வி டிசைன் ஃபார் 4.8 meter, adopt the value for the other places also, right. There is a wave coming here, there is a parameter called as wave period. The wave period, I said it can be from 5 seconds to 20 seconds. Then we have this wave height. What can be the range of wave height? Ocean engineering students, what will be the height of the wave?
3 meters.
Minimum to maximum. Minimum we will take 1 foot is generally taken as the wave. We will get less than that also. Okay, 0.3 meters to. What do you think will be the maximum wave height?
5, 7, 8 times.
Never thought. How many are ocean engineering? Raise your hands. 1, 2, 3, 4. That's all. How much? what will be the wave height in Bombay High? Then placement you will not get. Somebody will come and ask you what is the wave height in Bombay High. Where is Bombay High? Others know where is Bombay, everybody know where is Bombay High. You do not know where is Bombay High. You know what is Bombay High? You do not know. Gulf of Mexico, you know. Gulf of Mexico, you know. What is Gulf of Mexico? There is a Gulf where we get the oil. India, we get the oil from offshore field in Bombay High. It is near Bombay only, but into the sea, Arabian Sea. What is the maximum wave height in Bombay High? See, there is a handbook by Chakrabarti, you see that. I think Bombay High is not given, but it is given for many seas. North Sea, you know, where is North Sea? Where is North Sea? Huh? Where is it? But you are not ocean engineering, that is correct only. North of UK and Norway, that is called as North Sea. That is another field where we get the oil. Maximum wave height is in North Sea only. It can go up to even 30 meters. Bombay High is 16 meters. Where is Godavari Basin? Where is Godavari Basin? Must be in Andhra only. Reliance field, where is it? Gas field. Krishna Godavari Basin. We have Kaveri Basin is there, between Pondicherry and Kadalur, where we get the oil. Eastern side, the wave heights are higher. About 20, 22 meters it will be there. So we have this parameter is called as H. Based on wave period, we get one parameter that is called as G is acceleration due to gravity, L is wavelength. We call it as L naught, it is deep water wave height. You can simplify as 1.56 T square. Suppose for 10 second wave, this will be 156 meter, T is equal to 10 second. Wavelength will be 156 meters. We have three parameters, non-dimensional parameters. One is called as D by L, another is called as H by L, third one is called as D by L, capital D by L. These are the three parameters. Ocean engineering people might have studied this. What is the significance of small d by L? When is it called deep water?
Greater than
0.5. Suppose you have a pile supported structure here, which is used as a berthing structure, its diameter is D. What is the significance of capital D by L?
Diffraction.
Diffraction. When is it? When does it take place?
D by 2 less than, D by 2 like greater than 0.2.
0.2. Then they say 0.15 also. So if it is greater than 0.2, then diffraction will take place. For pile supported structure, it won't be in diffraction regime, it will be in Morrison regime. D by L will be less than 0.2. So this is called as diffraction parameter. This is called as steepness. What is this called? Relative water depth. So if it is greater than 0.5, it is deep water. Then we have shallow water and things like that, that you will see later. Now wave steepness we will see. What is the maximum wave steepness?
1 by 7.
So if H by L is greater than 1 by 7, tan H KD, then waves will break. K is 2 pi by L. T is water depth. There are two conditions of breaking. One is when the wave steepness is more than 1 by 7 tan H KD, 10 HKD will be equal to 1 for deep waters. So, for this wave, what is the maximum wave height it can have? H by L is 1/7. So, H will be 1/7 into 156. So, the wave height is 22.2 meters, the waves will break. Is it clear? A 10 second wave, when it is traveling, if the wave height becomes more than 22.2, even in the mid to ocean, the wave will break. Wave breaks means it breaks and it generates smaller waves like that. That is a wave breaking that takes place. That is in deep water, where the water depth is more than 100, 200 or 300 meters like that. Now, we have only very small water depth, 4.8. So, for this, the waves will break when H by D is equal to greater than 0.78. So, if you have a 10 meter water depth, you can have maximum wave height of 7.8 meters only. Clear? When the wave is breaking, before breaking, your wave height will go like this. What is the difference between this curve and this curve? It is a linear wave, it is a non-linear wave. What is the difference? The crest height is about 70 to 80% of the total height, whereas in a linear wave, the crest height is equal to 50% of the total height. Before breaking, what happens is the crest height increases to about 70 to 80%, then it breaks. When the wave is breaking on the structure, the force is enormous. Is it clear? When the wave is breaking, the force is enormous. So, this wave, what we are calling is H max. Significant wave height is H max divided by 1.62, we put 1.8, sometime they will say it is equal to 2 also. So, what is that we are talking is, when a wave is coming, the waves will be coming something like this. You will have waves like this, the different wave periods, wave heights and things like that. You take all the waves and take an average, that is called as H average. You take the maximum of the wave, that is called as maximum, H maximum. Significant means, out of, let us say there are about 12 waves, you take 4 waves and take the average, that is called as a significant wave height. That is top 1/3 of the waves you take, it is significant. But do not take on 12 waves and all, you have to take minimum about 500 or 1000 waves. Take, if you take 1000 waves, top 333 waves you take and take an average, that will be your significant wave height. So, the relationship between significant and maximum wave height is given here, H max by 1.6. The group of wave means something like this, the significant wave height comes like in a group continuously. So, here it is up small, small like that, but when a group of waves means wave heights of same size, comes for about 2 to 3 minutes or 5 to 6 minutes like that. Even if you have designed for HS, it would have failed. Normally, it does not happen, that group of waves. So, now we come to the problem, that is maximum wave height, significant wave height. So, you can calculate 0.78 into 4.8, 3.744 by 1.6, 2.34 meters. Then there is a formula by Hudson, and another thing is this is another criteria which you have to show. Assuming armor unit is rough quarry stone, what is the opposite to rough? What is opposite to rough? I do not know, that is why I am asking. I have something in my mind. What is opposite to rough? Don't say not rough and all. What is opposite? tell, yeah, you don't know what is opposite to rough. Huh? Rough, smooth you are telling. That I also thought that rough means that stone should, when you don't try to make it very smooth, rounded and things like that. Don't use that. When you use for a armor stone, don't try to cut the edges, like what you are doing for a statue or for a temple wall and things like that. You should not use like that. Clear, no? It should be rough. We have to use two layers. It is very important. There are certain armor blocks where you use single layer, otherwise you have two layers. Then this is the formula. W is the weight of individual armor unit. WR is the unit weight of armor. H here what you use is a significant waveguide. KD is a stability coefficient which is given as 1. SR is given in the next slide, I think. And cot theta, theta is the angle of structure slope measured with horizontal. SR is WR by WW. WR is the density of stone and WW is the density of water. That is why I have given in the problem water density. You substitute and get the weight of the stone is 2.585. Civil engineering, we always round 2.585 to 3. Don't round 2.6 and so you use 3 ton stone. So with this we will complete the class today. So you are calculating W, you substitute all the values here. I don't know what slope I have assumed. I think cot theta is assumed is 1.5. I have given 1:1.2, 1:2 on the sea side, but since the water depth is small, we go in for 1.5. Okay.